Welcome back to Tangata Pacifica, to South Auckland now, where the talk of gangs brings up the usual stereotypes.
Lowlifes, thugs, unruly criminals, just to name a few.
Yep, all of those, Tom, but there's one group of bikies that's bucking that trend.
Yes, our reporter Vea Mafile'o meets a bikie group who are on one road, and one road only.
It can be a daunting sight on the road. The menacing leathers, the roar of the bikes, they look like scary biker guys on a dangerous mission. And on the mission these guys are, they are members of the Redeemed Motorcycle Ministry.
Guys who have got out of jail, we've had guys who have been right into manufacturing of drugs and, you know, living such a bent life. We definitely pursue peace rather than violence, and the cross and the Redeemed symbolises that. We're trying to help people. So that's what the Redeemed is all about, pointing people to that answer.
Behind the passionate group of born-again Christians is President Amos Ali Parisi. And like most of the members, he comes from a background of drug abuse and gang life.
Our father used to own a billiard room in Glenelg. We used that as a pad without my father knowing. That's when we formed the gang called the Headhunters. Everywhere we went, we got pulled over, going to jail as well, you know, and you have to take the rap for someone. If the cops pick you, well, you can't knock on your mate. Yeah, I have done some bad stuff to end up in jail and that. I think back on it and sometimes I think, you know, a lot of people got hurt. Yeah, especially my family.
Amos left the gang scene but had more demons to face.
I was involved with drugs and that, and you've got to do something to feed your habit. I used to take some money from my parents and that, and they had no money, but you know they needed that money, but I still took it and that.
They broke through the door with guns.
His wife Leslie was also addicted to drugs, and the couple were in danger of getting their three young children taken away from them.
It wasn't very nice for the kids, and I think it scared them for quite a while.
The turning point was when my daughter was going to church, and she was only six. So I heard about churches, the cults and all that, and I had to talk to my wife that we should go and have a look. And I've never seen a church that sort of have a band in it, you know, and they were lifting their hands up in the air going like this and praising God. And I thought they were on drugs, actually. But the word that the pastor spoke was so true because it was all about me. Everything he said was so true, and it was about my life, how I was running my life. When I gave my heart to the Lord, he spoke to me and gave me a vision. Start a motorbike ministry. Not only bad people ride bikes, but Christians as well.
And with that, Amos and Leslie swapped the drugs for a natural high. Amos dusted off his jacket and now rides with a whole new crew. The ministry get involved in many community events, from parades to fundraisers, and even talking in schools.
When he came roaring in with his motorbike, a lot of the kids and even staff were a bit concerned because they thought that gang member had come down to sort some issue in the school. Being Samoan, he related to a lot of our Pacifica youth. He's got a ministry that no one else, I believe, has. And I think he can really touch people in certain areas of the community that there is hope.
We rode into the school, and I took my helmet off, and all the little girls went, "Oh, it's a lady." And I knew instantly why I was there. We encourage the children to come along to any things that we have. We are a family ministry, so the guys with their wives sometimes come, children, and it's gorgeous.
The main thing for the Redeem is to reach out to the lost people and people who need help.
One of those people needing help was mongrel mob member Seal. In 2007, when Nikki Cruz was here, Seal met Amos for the first time.
I am a ministry, Christian ministry in supporting. I am a Pela Mako, a skilty, Kokalaman Nico Bush. Over our Yanaro Kurumla Fanga Kuya, Tokla Fanga Way, La Poma. It was a local case young of a swinging papa. Your mama foot of Lama Lusoya, Emosolo, your fair king, electricity, so far reading. Lala Fuma Fuka, your life fell up, purpostal. While a lap of purpostal if I papa Q. Meet there for different members, but it's just good life. It's good life for me, yeah. Well, get there for the fish and the local home of Hangout. When you're feeding more, you would have put a little bit of the same Mako family.
That's me, that's Amos.
He hasn't got the afro, he's still a good looking guy though. He's become more focused than our family and our children. There's a softness, he's a good provider. Goes to work and lets me go shopping.
They still look rough around the edges and they still ride bikes. But the road they travel on is one of redemption.
A lot of people believe that I couldn't change, and even I believe that myself. You know, I even thought, no, I'm not going to change. But Jesus changed my life. Redemption songs,
these songs of freedom. Seal, you're an inspiration. What an amazing change in your life. Now, the Redeemed have a charity ride on the 24th of July to raise funds for 11-year-old Lisa Marie Jefter.
She has a terminal case of muscular dystrophy, and the brave girl is planning her funeral. Go to our website for more information.